this.
Should we get the fish head's hat on? Alright, toss him in.
Yo, that was on the big gulp. Big baits, big fluke. I mean, that's a beautiful bait, though. Look at that. And that glow head.
The head, yeah, yeah, yeah.
How are you? It's Dante, Magictail Outfitters. Today, we're going to do a little fluke fishing for a couple hours. Show you some of the products that we offer and we make. First off, for fluke fishing, our biggest product that we offer is the 3 and 5 pack bulk jigs. And our roundhead eye hoochies. Those are our most popular jigs we make. We also make bucktails now. Roundhead eye bucktails from 1/4 ounce up to 6 ounces in 5 different colors. White, sharp, pink shine, glow, and sand eel. Another product we have, we don't sell as many to the shops, but we also have, is an ultra minnow style hoochie. Main rods that we offer for fluke fishing, our interior series 7'1" to 4. We also have 7'6" through 6. Those are two original rods we made for both tog jigging and fluke jigging. On the conventional side, we have currently 2 different options. We have a 7'2" to 6 and a 7'6" through 8. Both are our acid wrapped rods, phenomenal fluke fishing, the light, moderate bend. Also for the guys who like a little lighter tackle, we have a 3/4 to 2 ounce 7-foot rod. All three of these are in over 70 shops in the Northeast. You can check them out. If you have any questions, you can always find us on our website, www.magictailoutfitters.com. Any questions, we'll be happy to answer. Hopefully we catch a couple fish today.
What's up? It's Captain Gregg Cutting, Fishhead Charters, based out of Barnegat Inlet, New Jersey. It's the north end of LBI. Light tackle, inshore captain here, running a 25-20 Parker sport cabin for 1 to 3, 1 to 4 anglers, doing family-friendly trips all summer long, also fishing in the spring and the fall seasons. Main target species are striped bass and fluke. I also do some tog and sea bass, but striped bass is really my game on species. Do some light tackle fly fishing, and also cast retrieving some lures to striped bass and some structure. Here in Long Beach Island, I also run the general manager of Fishermans Headquarters Bait and Tackle Shop in Ship Bottom, where we sell all the essential needs to get a good day on the water, saltwater fishing, whether it's tuna fishing offshore, inshore fishing in the bay for maybe weak fish or stripers, or maybe you're looking for some crabbing and clamming gear. Stop by Fishermans Headquarters, gear up today. So right now it's early mid-September time frame here in the Central Jersey coast. It's kind of when we have a good fluke bite in the ocean. It's when we get some of the warmest waters of the season. Today we're out about 65, 70 foot of water fishing some local wrecks and reef sites here in New Jersey. Thankfully we have a good artificial reef program at the state that has some awesome fishing opportunities. We also have a lot of natural wrecks that occurred over many years. Today we're fishing a barge out, like I said, 65, 70 foot of water. Fishing little jigs from Magictail, 1 ounce, ounce and a half, 2 ounce. As you see, it's almost Lake Atlantic conditions, a small little ground swell in the water. A little bit of a breeze, got the Rodan down, keeping us in the spot. It's a GPS anchor trolling motor. Basically throwing these little jigs up, let them settle down here in the current. Kind of tapping them along the way. You see Dante's kind of doing a couple little jigs and taps. You feel the bite, you set the hook, and reeling a couple flukies. We've been having a pretty good bite so far today. No big fish we can come looking for, so maybe we'll move around and check out some other spots, but see what we can put together here.
I like it.
I do.
Right? And,
I was going to say.
I always fish it like with conventional, and that getting good. Then I stop and test.
So obviously, as I like when I get the charters, I'll show up and drift and do 2-3 drifts. And I try to keep the boat in reverse. Like I'll stay on the motor to slow it down. I'm like, all right, they're either here or they're not. And if I get a good nibble, then I'll throw the trolling motor down. But I tend to move around a lot. Like I bump this, like tap it. I'm not just sitting in one little spot.
That's why I like casting, because they can catch on.
Yeah. Let me come underneath you. We're 80 feet off, so let me get you a little closer.
Okay.
You drifted off.
Sea bass.
You under the boat?
Oh, Fluke.
Is there a space to load with Fluke? Good luck catching bigger ones.
I'm going to fish a 2-ounce roundhead glow bucktail. I got 30-pound line with just a loop swivel and a 6-inch gulp. Ready to get back here.
Hold on a second, I just want to get us right on the spot. You're drifting into it right now.
I don't think you gotta be. These fish are everywhere here. Loaded with little fluke.
Still off this spot though. 28 feet away.
Loaded with fluke. You can't even hit the bottom. There you go, Greg. That's 2 fluke that were caught on the spot lock. So if you never saw it, there you go. See how easy it is? Just cast around the wreck. It's literally cheating. Another little guy.
So personally, I like fluke fishing with the Magictail 0.25-1. This is their 7-foot light that I have here. Magictail makes some awesome rods. Lightweight, really simplistic, bare bones, nothing fancy, no need for the crazy fancy stuff adding weight. But what I really like is the action of the rods. They have a real powerful mid and back section with a very sensitive and forgiving tip. Some fishing styles, you know, you want a really quick, fast action rod, real fast taper. Personally, for fluke fishing, I like a little bit of a slower, not saying a slow rod, but slower than most of these super fast action rods that you'll find. What I tend to like about it is when I hook up with a fish or I set the hook, a little more forgiving, it stays tight. Fluke tend to have this little head slap, kind of shake, and like this little reverse that they pull. And I feel like a softer tipped rod really helps out keeping that hook tight and keep from shaking it. I tend to fall into the pulled hook issues when you fish a really fast action rod.
Yep.
But with saying that, these rods aren't slow. They're, you know, they're very powerful and quick, but the taper tends to have a little more forgiving, say, top 1/3, you know, of the profile.
Bite there.
So I just broke off in the wreck here. I'm just tying up a new leader. What I like to do with fishing this light braided line is tie a triple overhand knot, which is basically, I believe it's called a surgeon's loop. Just do 1, 2, hold on. 1, 2, 3, triple overhand, pull that tight. Then I'm tying a uni to uni over top of that double line. I find it makes a much stronger connection. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's the one uni, and I'll tie the other side in the double braid.
Babies. So what's the deal with these striper 20s? Still gonna run it?
I know. That's what I do. Doubled up, uni to uni, and I tie a single jig on here. Go 2 ounce. Personally, fluke fishing, I like to use Magictail roundhead jigs, just a naked jig head. Nothing fancy, nothing special. No need for jewelry or fancy feathers and skirts. Some people like the bucktails, some people like the hoochies. I just like a naked jig head. Sometimes I'll fish a teaser up above. Sometimes I'll also fish a single drop kind of rig too, which is on the other rod there. Right now in the structure, I'm just kind of trying to get in and out of that cover with a small little jig. And I'm gonna put a 6-inch grub on. Gold grub. Pink shine's my go-to last few years, but I also fish the white glow. Kind of rig it up like that. I'm gonna cast it up current here. Catch a couple flukies. So right now, like in the summertime, we got the water temperatures. These fluke come up into the shallows and the bays all summer long, kind of do their thing back there. It's a good summertime fishery here in Barnegat Bay, Long Beach Island area. A lot of times the water maxes out, water temperature up in the upper 70s, 80 degrees, mid 80s. You'll have kind of the mass exodus, so a lot of these fish start leaving there July and August. There's still some good fluke fish in the bay in August, but for the most part, that's really when the ocean inshore water speed up. Yeah?
At least in our bay, this bay. You know, your bay, your life's a little better. You got cleaner water.
That's a better fish, bro.
That's a better one.
When
did you get a net?
Maybe we'll see. That's a keeper.
Oh, yeah. Oh! That's why you net fluke.
Nice net job.
Look at that.
That's a keeper.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Nice inshore fluke. Probably 20 inch.
19, 20 inch, right?
19, 3/4.
Good one for the dinner table.
Sheep.
So usually if I get bit off close to the hook there, if I look where the ribs are, I save it for, sometimes I'll put it on a sea bass hook, but I got a little bit of a nub tail. I'll keep fishing that, got a little flipper to it, but when it's just a total slug, a little cigar piece, I get rid of it personally. But back to what you were saying, you know, summertime, we have a good inshore fishing in the backwaters, Barnegat Bay, backside of LBI and all the local channels. Main thoroughfares, intercoastal waterways and such. But this is my favorite time to fluke fish when you kind of get out in the ocean, get out of kind of those congested waterways in the bay, get out in the ocean, fish these local reefs and wrecks.
August, fluke. September, October is the best.
Yeah.
Too bad we can't fish.
Too bad the season's closed.
They start going on offshore wrecks, you start getting a lot bigger fish.
But for the most part, these fish are out in the deeper water areas in the wintertime. Right, they, in the winter they migrate out east to the edge of the shelf, and for the most part they all move in along the summertime. But there's still a lot of fish in the inshore waters.
A That's when I'm a little quarter ounce teaser.
It's funny, my first drop with the 2 ounce, got the keeper. All my other bites of fish are all shorts. Maybe there's a correlation, we'll see.
I'm talking bad on the roundhead jigs, he catches the biggest fish. I like my hoochies. The reason we made the roundhead jigs is because so many people lose so much tackle fishing on a structure like this, on rock piles, the wrecks. I think I lose 10. Well, you know, 10 Spro bucktails or 10 beaches. $90-$100 a day in tackle.
Drop it.
So these roundhead jigs were selling 3 or 5 packs. A lot cheaper. In our line is insane.
Yeah, what's up with that?
Whoa.
Is there a heavy one there?
We got a heavy one here. Get the net! Feels like a little better one. Should be a keeper here. I haven't really seen too many big fish today, but it should be a keeper size. Pretty strong current.
A lot more current out here.
Yeah, he's a little guy.
It's a monster!
That might be a snot. He choked it though. Let's see.
How big was it?
It wasn't 17.
Where are you? I'm moving straight down.
It's crazy how much better one wreck is.
That was dead.
Piece, crush them. Go to the next piece, not a touch.
But do you think it's just the piece that you're on? The section of the piece? No?
Because you gotta think. Especially for Tom. These small pieces.
The fish move around?
Yeah. And they move around and they.
You think they're like tucked in tight to a cave, little crevices?
Maybe on like really deep offshore wrecks.
Yeah. I always feel like sometimes like you either adjust the ropes or adjust the trolling motor,
I think you
and you
can
start a bite
fish.
Up, you know, like if you're like kind of off kilter or something.
Yeah, absolutely.
The currents bring your lines maybe further off than you think they are and you're not as tight. Speaking of trolling motor, let's give it a little bump up here a little bit. Quick up, one quick left. Let's see where we go.
Crazy one. Our lines are that way, but our jigs are up that way.
So word is it's pouring rain back on land?
See.
It sure looks like it is. Somebody told me it's just be beautiful out here today.
Who's that?
It was you.
It's at 4 o'clock, I said. He's fishing the quarter ounce to 1 ounce light rod. A little light for me, but he's liking it. He's fishing the 2 ounce jig on it. Just short of being a slot, probably.
Right, probably 16 inch fish.
Yeah.
15 and a half. A
lot of them out here.
So he's got kind of clamped down on my tail, so I'm going to give him a second to open up. Don't want to be ripping my tails off here. So I actually tagged some fluke. I haven't had a recapture yet, though. I tagged a few striped bass, dude. Remember that tournament we fished last year?
Yeah.
We tagged? Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. I had
this
three.
Spring?
Yeah, so we tagged it in the fall, right off Island Beach State Park. I tagged a couple in Barnegat Inlet. They were recaptured this spring. I'm sorry. Yeah, no, we did it last fall. We tagged them. This spring they were recaptured. One was in Sandy Hook, and one was off Montauk. Yeah, I got the data.
Which one was Montauk? The big one?
The smaller one.
Really?
The bigger one was by Sandy Hook. Two were actually recaptured in Sandy Hook. They were caught like a week, 2 weeks apart.
But you're riding bayfish.
Yep.
So we are seeing riding bayfish.
100%.
Because people don't think we do.
Oh, 100% we do.
See, all we see is Delaware and Chesapeake.
No way. No way. Yeah, so we're out here fishing 75, 80 foot of water. A couple wrecks, a little cluster of wrecks here. Fishing some small Magictail jigs and bucktails, some hoochies. Kind of bopping them in and out of the wrecks, out of the structure.
There he is. Oh, I missed mine.
They schwacked me. Ooh, he's got a little spunk to him. Let's go.
Isn't it amazing that two different wrecks, 500 feet apart? One of them's loaded with, that's a keeper. Swing him in. That might be a slot. Hopefully that's a slot fish. 17, 1799. Money.
Yep, slot fish.
There we go.
And what I personally like to do is get the fish in the live well right away, keep them alive in there, and I slice their gillet there and bleed them out in the live well, and then I ice them up once they bleed real good. They fillet much nicer that way.
You know, the best way to fillet them.
2 days later.
Yep. So, I know this really doesn't matter, but my buddy's a chef at a high-end restaurant in Philly. And he says the best way to cut any fish, cook any fish, is after 3 days on ice. So,
it's firm.
You know when fish get rigor mortis and they get stiff after ice? You want to go through that whole process. So after a couple days, they become soft again. And that's supposedly the best.
Really?
Yeah, my buddy owns the restaurant Blackfish. Ooh, Chip Roman. Right?
Yeah.
And that's how he says it's best.
Swung for the fences there, bro.
I hit him. It's crazy. One wreck is so much better than so close.
So you saw that. That was a 17 and a half inch fish on the 8 inch.
Yeah.
The first slot of the day. Is that the first slot? Comes on the 8 inch grub. I'm telling you, the small fish love them.
Are they on sale at your place?
They're on sale.
Look at that. I know they're on sale everywhere. I think people are having trouble getting rid of them.
I love them.
Yeah?
I don't like the price, but I love the baits. So that was a good fun day. Fishing the inshore waters here out of Barnegat Light aboard Fishhead Charters. Went out and did some fluke jigging with some Magictail products. Putting some work on the jigs, fishing some gulp. Also used the Magictail spinning rods. I was personally using the 7 foot light. Caught a bunch of fluke, mostly shorts, but a couple slots, a couple overs. It was a good fun day. And for the most part, I think it was a successful trip, nice weather. That was that. Hopefully you guys wanna get out and do some fluke fishing in the summertime season. We're just getting around to the ending of it here, and I guess the 27th of September. But fluke season normally opens up in the Jersey Shore area, on the Jersey coast, New Jersey State. Normally early to mid-May, and the season runs till normally mid-September. You guys wanna get down, get on some good fluke fishing Jersey Shore, come to Long Beach Island, get geared up with fishing tackle at Fishermans Headquarters. If you need a private charter, looking to get on a boat, check out Fishhead Charters. That's my light tackle guide service, fishheadlbi.com.